So was I missing something in the 90s? I mean, it seems like a lot of people were somewhat familiar with SWAT Cats, and from what I can tell, it was an action comedy series about two junkyard cats who fight crime using jets and other Batman-like weapons in a city full of humanoid cats. Ah, furries. So in the game based on the show, you got your choice between T-Bone and Razor, each with their own gameplay mechanics. Razor can jump high and is quick, but his gun isn't very powerful. Boo-hoo. T-Bone is slower and can't jump that high, but his gun can take people out on their ass in two hits. You know, while we're on the topic of this gun, let's talk about hit detection. In games, the rule of thumb should pretty much always be, if you hit the edge of a sprite, it should count as a hit. I mean, right? Oh, but in SWAT Cats, you already have a super short-range gun, but it has to hit dead center. Bull crapatootie. But anyways, now get this. T-Bone has a rocket launcher that can't hurt enemies, and Razor has a jetpack that catches fire and literally kills them!
Brilliant!
But, you know, with comparatively basic weapons that clearly don't work right, it's amazing their jet works so well. Oh, their jet works, I guess. But boy, oh boy, do we get to experience that Mode 7 graphics at its absolute worst. Crap. Okay, so I just complained about how Inchester cheated Too Cool to Fool. My eyes hurt at times. But here's what I want you to do for the next several seconds. I'm gonna stop. I want you to put this video in full screen mode. Okay, you done it? Now put your face 5 inches from the screen. Okay, there? And try to endure this for as long as possible without vomiting on your monitor. That's pretty much what I experienced playing this on a standard size TV, and on top of Chester Cheetah's skateboard levels blinding me, I'm now blind and nauseous. Blah! Thank you, SWAT Cats. You know, I understand T-Bone and Razor aren't actual SWAT team members, but can you imagine if the SWAT team really was made of cats? That would be so good! Further proving my theory that cat heads make everything better. Now, I've kind of railed into this one because the game will initially turn you off with its crappy areas, but if you stick with it, it actually becomes kind of okay. I mean, not good by any means, but just beyond passable. It has pretty decent music, high difficulty, and to be honest, some kind of epic moments. I mean, if you got nothing else better to do and you've exhausted Super Mario World and Super Metroid, you might actually give this one a shot. Now I just gotta go learn more about this cartoon.